I'm a neuro-oncologist at Walter Reed National Military Medical Center, which is across the street from the NIH. And so I primarily see patients over there where I serve as the DOD's only neuro-oncologist. I'm a clinical collaborator with the neuro-oncology branch here at the NCI, and I see patients and I participate in the research program here at the neuro-oncology branch. So I think much like the rest of the branch here, you know, I'm focused on the NCI Connect program and trying to develop trial ideas for rare CNS cancers. And so I'm fortunate to get to participate as an investigator in the ongoing trials here, which includes a basket trial of a checkpoint inhibitor in patients who have rare CNS cancers through the NCI Connect program. But I think beyond that, it's to step up to the challenge to develop more trials that more of our patients with rare CNS cancers can participate in. And I think, you know, we're going to have some examples upcoming in the next year where we're going to be able to offer other novel treatment types to patients with rare CNS cancers as a part of the NCI Connect program. And I think even beyond that, it's to collaborate with other institutions or other partner institutions and both refer patients for clinical trials and hopefully develop clinical trials together that patients can participate in. So some of the tumors that we're focusing on in the NCI Connect, there's less than 1,000 diagnosed per year. Some there's only a few hundred diagnosed per year. So there's just a small number of patients, and it's hard to gain a lot of experience even throughout a neuro-oncology career. I'm seeing these patients. And when you think about trying to get a group of patients together for a single clinical trial, that would be very difficult. There's only a few hundred patients of a particular rare tumor type, let's say PXA, pleomorphic xanthoastrocytoma. If there's only a few hundred diagnosed per year, well, a smaller subset of that patients would actually need a clinical trial for treatment. So you start talking about very small numbers of patients. So a single institution trying to do a trial on a single rare CNS cancer type is very challenging and really requires coordinated multi-institutional efforts to be successful. So I think, you know, the big advantage is to be seen by doctors, nurses, other medical professionals who have seen your cancer type before, who have heard a story like yours before, and it's not the first time that they will have seen this cancer type. You know, with the subspecialization of medicine, you know, patients are being put into smaller and smaller silos. There's hundreds of different types of cancer, most of which I as a neuro-oncologist do not know how to take care of. But when it comes to central nervous system cancer, there's really not a type of cancer or a situation that I probably haven't thought about or seen. And so I think that's important for peace of mind and to receive the best care possible when you're a patient who has a rare central nervous system cancer.
Learn more at cancer.gov/NCI-connect. Contact us, nciconnect@mil.nih.gov. 240-760-6530.
U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, National Institutes of Health, National Cancer Institute, cancer.gov, 1-800-4-CANCER. Produced May 2020.